gentlemen. We're doing a revised edition of our deadlift tape. Things have changed a lot since I made the first one in the early 90s. This is 2003. We now have 7 people over 800 in deadlift and countless, probably close to 100 over 7. We've actually had 5 R98s pull 700. So we're going to show you how we intertwine our training modern day with the bands and the chains and the conjugate training method and the spatial exercises and the undirected exercises and follow that. So let's get into this tape. We're going to get into some max effort deadlift programs, some speed deadlifts, and I'll explain as we go along the tape how this all fits together in a weekly, monthly, and yearly plan.
Thank you.
All right, folks, what you just witnessed is speed deadlift. We use bands. These bands at the top are about 220 pounds extra. First, you saw Jeremiah did six singles with a 325. Jeremiah is a 765-pound deadlifter and should pull eight his next meet. You notice he did them right on the platform, which is raised 1 inch. Then you saw Danny Blankenship and myself. We did six singles with the same weight, but we did them raised. We raised the platform up 2 additional inches. Now, Jeremiah pulls conventional. Danny trains conventional, pulls sumo. I train like conventional, pull sumo, but today I pulled sumo. And you notice we did six singles. Again, they're done immediately after speed squats. So basically, if you figure this out, if you want to calculate your own deadlift, at the floor, the weight would be approximately in the low 40% range, and at the top, it's in the low 70% range. This is speed. It builds speed strength. All right, now next we're going to move into some rack pulls. If you're a 600 deadlifter, then a pin of 660 or above is a waste of time. You're never going to lift those kind of weights. Or if you're a 700 deadlift, 770. So just keep that in mind. Actually, with the plates 2 inches off the ground, a lot of people here have a hard time pulling as much as a regular deadlift because off the floor, they can actually use leg drive. Also, how we use bands on the speed platform for speed pulls, we also put bands over the bar here. It makes it quite difficult lifting a barbell off these pins like that. So I'll tell you what, folks, let's move in next to the lightened deadlift method.